Damn, I can't go back to sleep. But anyway, yesterday my daughter went on a college trip with some seniors and juniors and some of the sophomores, right? And she didn't get back to her school till like around 7 p.m. yesterday, okay? So I always follow my intuition, okay? Because it got dark and everything. And so I said, my baby's still on, well, she on the way from her trip. So it took 4 hours and a half to get to her, to get to this college, right? And it took like, on a way back, it took like freaking 7 hours, you know? So it was longer coming back. So I always follow my intuition, right? So I knew something was wrong, right? I'm very fucking, ooh, intuitive. So I follow my intuition. So some told me, go meet your daughter. Go meet your daughter. Because I don't let her be outside at this time of night. I don't. She's like, when she come home from school, she's at home or she's with me out in the public taking care of business or going to the store whatsoever, right? So I said, well, damn, it done got dark down. She's still on the bus, her and her classmate or whatever. And I told her to text me. I said, text me, let me know what time you get on a bus and what time you get back to your school. So she did. So some told me, go meet your daughter, okay, at her school. It's dark and shit. And she's a girl. So I said, fuck that. I'm gonna go meet my baby, So, I left the house as I was like on my way to meet my daughter, right? I see this fat, well, I see two cars. I see two cars, right? And I knew what they were, stalkers. I knew they were some fucking narcissistic flying monkeys. So as I cross the street, I get closer. This, what the fuck is my cat doing? Oh, it's my cat knocking down shit. So I guess that's a sign right there. But as I get closer to the two cars, it's this one car gonna pull off real fast. It's a fat Mexican bitch. I saw her good. She had long hair hanging down, curly hair. She had her hair like in a pin up, in the ponytail up, and the rest hanging down. I've seen this fat bitch before. This bitch has stalked me before. All right. This is a fat Mexican bitch. Don't get me wrong. I don't have anything against Mexicans, Hispanic people, because my daughter is Hispanic. Okay. But this is fat Mexican lady. I seen this bitch before. Okay. So when she saw me, she must knew who the fuck I was. Because this bitch jet the fuck out real quick. But I saw her. All right. I had my camera on. All right. So as I was walking, I had my phone up, pretending like I was talking to someone on the phone, But at the same time, I was recording these stalkers. So as I started to get closer, this bitch got nervous and scared, a fat, funky Mexican bitch. Pulled off, and she was looking at me, right? I said, yeah, I know that bitch. I don't know if this bitch is a caseworker, coworker. I don't know what. saw this bitch work at a school, but I seen this bitch before. I seen this bitch when I was staying in Maywood stalking me and my child. So as this bitch pulled off, behind this bitch, it was a black bitch, a black older bitch, and another bitch on the side with blonde hair. So I put two and two together. I said, is these bitches stalking me? Is these bitches waiting on my daughter? Or something like that. So I put two and two together. I recorded the shit and I made a mistake and erased the motherfucking video. The Mexican bitch was in a dog gray looking car. It was a four-door car. All right. The bitch was bigger than her motherfucking car. So it was this black bitch had on a red blouse and a cap or something on her head or a wig. And I got closer to a car that I was recording. You know, I'm playing it. I'm like, I'm looking at him, like I'm talking to somebody on the phone. She was looking at me and shit, like looking at me like crazy. And I knew the bitches were stalking me. So I don't know if these bitches are caseworkers or they just motherfucking haters, stalkers, just stalking me, jealous of me, envying me. So I said, why is these people right here? And I always listen to my intuition. So I saw one, the Mexican bitch had a lightsaber, right? The bitch, Jedi, like, I'm talking about the bitch, like, burnt rubble, you know? So I saw her face and everything. And the black bitch, okay, the black female, they stayed right there in the car because they didn't want to give themselves away by pulling off so fast. But this Mexican bitch, she was scared and nervous. You could tell when the motherfucker is doing something bad they don't supposed to be doing. So this is some illegal shit. This bitch stalking me. Like I said, this could be a caseworker, authority figure. I don't know who this bitch is. Somebody's ex, somebody's wife, or whoever this bitch is. But I knew the bitch had something up her sleeves. I knew they were no good. So the black female and the other, they stayed in their car. I guess they didn't want to make themselves look suspicious, but you already did because I already knew what you was on. So whoever these people are, I think I know who they are, but I'm on to the S, okay? These people are fucking jealous of me and my daughter's relationship, all right? I feel like they are the same people that came into my life trying to destroy me and my daughter's relationship. I believe these people are connected to a school or to DCFS, okay? Now, I said to myself, like, these motherfuckers is crazy. Why is she stalking me? Why is she stalking my daughter? For some reason, they must knew what time my daughter would, you know, get home. They must knew something that she went on a trip or something. I know I said something about my daughter going on a trip when I recorded. But how these people know where I live, what area I live in, okay? And what street to park on. So these bitches been watching me. They've been watching me, y'all. Watch y'all kids. I'm telling you, these people are sick. What, my little boo-boo? These people are sick. I'm serious. These motherfuckers, I don't know if this is an ex-bitch from my, I don't know if this is my daughter's father, ex-comic partner, or a family member, or these people are jealous of me and jealous of my daughter, and they jealous of our relationship because I feel like somebody is giving information to my enemies. I feel like somebody that I know that's close to me have gave these people my address, have gave these people information about my whereabouts. Watch y'all, kids. Okay. Motherfuckers are sick. Motherfuckers are miserable. All right. And this shit been going on too long. When I first started YouTube, okay, I did, say something about DCFS because I was involved with DCFS. And like I said, and with UIC Hospital, I was betrayed by doctors and shit. And they had called DCFS on me for the wrong reason. They lied, they betrayed, they deceived me and everything. Okay. Even the court system. So these people are sick. They need help. And I, honest to God, I would kill a bitch over my child. I would kill you right there on the spot. If I have a feeling that you even tried to do anything to my child or me, I would take you the fuck out. For real. I will fucking take you out. All right? I get this harassing. I get this stalking shit a lot. Okay? But when it comes down to my daughter, bitch, you have met your match. You ready to die now. Already. You are ready to be in your motherfucking graveyard. Because I don't play that shit. I don't fuck with nobody. I mind my business. I take care of my child. I take care of myself. My cat. Her cat. I don't bother nobody. I don't stalk no one. I don't harass no one. So I'm putting two and two together like, is these some people? I know it's crazy, but I'm saying to myself, it's crazy. It's crazy how people can stalk you, harass you, and it don't bother me, but I will fuck you up. I will take you out. Straight up. I will take you out. You messing with the wrong bitch. You are fucking with the wrong person. I'm telling you right now. If you're miserable, whatever is going on in your motherfucking life, bitch, get a reality check. Go get a life. Go get some help. Go get some counseling. Go see a therapist, a psychiatrist. Because, bitch, I'm gonna fuck you up. I'm telling you right now. Don't stalk me. Don't stalk my child. So when I got to my daughter's school, it was a white car, right? And I don't know, like I said, was right there waiting. And when the white car saw me, that's when they came around. And my daughter, here come my daughter coming out of her school. And, you know, and here come this white car. When they saw my daughter walking, and so they saw me, and they, when they saw her, so they came out and turned the car, and they was driving slow, looking at me at the same time and at my daughter. Okay? This shit is crazy. It's crazy because people are fucked up in this world. I'm feeling spirit talking to me in my right ear. And these are my loved ones. My ancestors are talking to me. And they let me know that it's going to be all right. They let me know that I'm right. They let me know that I ain't got shit to worry about. That my daughter's protected. I'm protected. And I know I am. And I know she is. But you know, you just never know. But this, yeah, these people are weird. So I have a feeling that somebody betrayed me. This could be the, I won't be surprised. I have haters. Even when I take my daughter to her doctor appointment, I have haters there. It's crazy. And I never done anything to these people. These people stalks me. They roll their eyes at me. So they got to be racists. They got to be miserable.
unhappy with themselves, trying to make me unhappy, trying to make somebody else unhappy. That shit don't scare me. That shit don't fear me. Like I said, bitch, I will take you out. I will take you out. You fucking with the wrong person and you fucking with the right person. But yeah, these hoes thirsty. Yeah, these bitches thirsty. These some old bitches too and young. These hoes are sick. Okay? But yeah, this is what I go through, guys. It's sick. But like I said, I will take me a motherfucker out. I will take you the fuck out. Don't fuck with mine. Don't fuck with mine.